more interactive sessions. So if you, maybe if you have come across any of these VLSI topics, okay, and if it is relating to you or if it is interesting to you, or so if you get any doubt in between, you can stop. I want it more interactive. At least one of you, listen to this, and one of you choose to enter this VLSI domain, so I will be happy and this program is successful. That's all. So make a VLSI. See, I did my BTEC in 2004. Okay, so at least now you have lot of material online, right? So if you go to internet and you search for VLSI, you get a lot of material or lot of information. But think about, 20 years ago, a rural college student, right, getting into VLSI, how difficult it was. And nowadays, even though we have so much, so much information in, internet, and still people are not entering into this VLSI, not entering up into this domain, because either they may lack of information, and we are not looking exactly for that information, right? So internet has a lot of information, but we are not looking into that information. See, as a, if we see college point of view, they want to get you placed, right? Whether it is in VLSI or in Java or anything, right? See, being an electrical student or electronic student who studied electronics for some time, and we get into other means of domains like Java or something like this, right? Why it happens? Because either we don't have the information or clarity, what is there for me, right? So what this 1 hour talk, or I'll try to wrap it in half an hour, and let's we have a question and answers. So, make a VLSI. Anyone who is aspiring, let's see, what is the end goal for us? What is the end goal? Mostly getting a job, right? That is the end goal. But why we choose electrical? I think most of you are electrical students, right? Why you choose electrical? Is it your decision?
Yes.
Is it your decision?
Yes.
Purely?
Yes.
Nobody cares?
No.
That's great actually. So, only very less people choose their interest. Most of them, it is inspired by either parents or uncles or somebody else who is working in that, they choose this domain for us. Maybe the same way for career also. It's not we choose the career, it's somebody else chooses the career for us. Or somebody pushes into that career. Most of the times it happens. But maybe very less chance that, they choose where they are working, they choose what they want to work. That is very rare. And, if it happens to you, then you are the right path actually. Okay? So, there is something which made you to choose this domain, right? Okay, I'm leaving that and joining a software company which is completely irrelevant. So how that satisfies your choice, right? It doesn't matter. So let us see maybe one by one so that you get some information out. History, right? History, some examples we get, job market, that's what we are very interested in, right? See, first of all, to choose something, we should know the job market, right? And we should know salaries, first of all, right? That is the important factor. If salaries are good, we choose it. Yes, sir? Yeah. Let's see some. Okay. So, have you seen vacuum tubes? Have you seen vacuum tube? Not any. No, right? Not in our labs. So, before implementing that transistor, so to what is transistor? What we use for? Let it be more interactive. What is transistor? Sir, don't ask questions. You say what you want to say and leave, right? See, generally transistors we use for either switches or amplification, right? Like we get the low signal, we amplify it. So that we use for transistors. Before transistor was invented, we were using vacuum tubes. Vacuum tubes are very huge in size, okay? To get the functionality of our amplification, we need how many transistors we need to amplify the signal? How many? One transistor. That's good. Okay. So to have that one transistor, we have to, you know, when we go for a vacuum tube, it occupies a lot of space. Think about, you know, I got a chance to visit, you know, these radio stations 20 years ago. When I saw that, still they were using the old technology, vacuum tubes. The simple amplification circuit, it was a big room. Just an amplification circuit, okay, tube, you know, transistors and, you know, some components. It was big room. It was occupying complete room. So, after inventing the transistor, who invented transistor? So, after inventing the transistor, so everything got changed. The way we look at electronics got changed. Right? The way we look at electronics got changed. So, now it is a transistor. It was like, you know, we could have synced complete circuit by minimum, I'm saying, 1000 times by then. From vacuum tube to transistor, it has scaled by 1000 times. Okay. Now, scientists, they were able to, you know, do circuits in a less space. Okay. So then, after inventing the transistors, now some scientists got this curious question: Why can't we integrate a lot of transistors on a single silicon? I mean, we use silicon and germanium for, you know, high single sign. Why can't we integrate more components on a single silicon? So they tried, they succeeded. That's where the name integrated circuits came into existence. Integrated circuit. They integrated passive and active components. You know what is passive and active, right? I assume that you know. So passive, resistor, capacitor, active, diode, transistor, MOSFETs, whatever. So they try to integrate more than one component on a single silicon substrate, and they call it integrated circuit. We are integrating, right? So this was the first. What is this? First integrated circuit. Okay, and this was vacuum tube. And this is the first commercial IC they sold. First commercial IC. So they have you know, at least 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. So maybe 2 inputs, 3 inputs, 2 outputs, and a, you know, few transistors here. By looking at this also, we can analyze 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 transistors are there.